Good morning, dear students. Let me welcome the 9th class students to this session of English 2. As you know, we have been discussing a topic called the correct use of adjectives. Last class, we discussed many things about the correct use of adjectives, including what exactly the adjectives and what different types of adjectives and some of the instructions given to us to use adjectives correctly while speaking as well as for writing. And today we will also learn some more instructions for using adjectives correctly. And before going to understand those instructions for correct use of adjectives, let's have a little concentration. And for that, please sit Siddha with Dhyana Mudra and with closed eyes, have Brahmanath. Dear students, let me again welcome you. And let's discuss and understand the other instructions for using adjectives correctly in our speech and writing. Okay? For that, let me write something on the board. Dear students, let's understand the next rule for using adjectives correctly. What this rule says, let's understand, okay? It says, the superlative degree of an adjective, take the before it. So, whenever we are using normally a superlative degree before a noun, it must take the article the before it, okay? Normally, superlative degrees take the article the before it, okay? So, now let's understand the example given over here. This plan is the best of all. This plan is the best of all. That means of all plans. Understand? So similarly, he is the most intelligent boy in our class. He is the most intelligent boy. You see the best, most intelligent, both these adjectives take the article the before them. It is normal whenever we use any superlative degree, we must use the before the degree. Understand? And from these two examples, it is clear. Next it is to see, sometimes it has some contradictory ideas, contradictory views, contradictory things that sometimes we don't need to use the before the superlative degrees. In what cases we don't need to use the the before the superlative degrees is given over here, this contradiction. Please understand. What is this? Here you see. But the is not used in the following cases. What are those cases when we don't need to use the before the superlative degree? Okay, so now see, when the superlative degree has a possessive adjective, when a superlative degree has a possessive adjective before it, we don't need to use the before that. Possessive adjectives like my, your, his, her, its, understand? So, in that case, we don't need to use the before the superlative degree because before them there is a possessive adjective. You see, example is given. He is my best friend. Here, normally best is a superlative degree. We need to use the before it. But since my, which is a possessive adjective used before this superlative degree, it is not necessary to use the before the superlative degree. Okay? So similarly, it was her darkest act. It was her darkest act. Understand? So here the darkest is a superlative degree of this act is functioning as an adjective. But before this superlative degree, we have a possessive adjective like mine. So due to the use of these possessive adjectives, we did not need to use the before the superlative degrees. This is not only that case. Some other cases also, we don't need to use the before the superlative degrees. Let's understand this. When the superlative degree is used with a noun and for the sake of address, here address means what? Address means to speak to someone else. Address means not writing the address when we are sending the letters to somebody else or a location address. Here address is to speak to. Understand? The minister is addressing the people in the gathering. Understand? So when we need to have the addresses, we don't need to use the before the superlative degrees. So the example is given over here. Oh, dearest son. Here is the dearest is the superlative degree of this son. Oh, dearest son. Here, oh is talking about addressing the son. Oh, dearest son, when will you back again? When will you back again? Oh, dearest son, when will you back again? So here in this case, we don't need to use the before this superlative degree. Similarly, here you see, oh, kindest son. Oh, kindest son, how I pine without you? How I pine without you? Here pine is a very different word. Pine means becoming happy. Here in the sense, becoming jolly, becoming, making our heart evergreen, means always becoming happy. So if this kindest soul is not with us, how can we have the joy in our heart and mind? Okay, so this is the rule that normally we use the before the superlative degree, but when there is superlative degree is having a possessive adjective, or when we are addressing to someone, we don't need to use the before the superlative degree. This is the rule. Okay, let's understand the next rule. You understood this? The examples and everything given? Okay, next, let's understand next rule. Here the next rule is that, for using adjectives correctly, let's understand. The superlative must not be used as if it were equal to very plus positive. Very plus positive. So when we know that while using it is possible that we can use very plus positive adjective, then it is not necessary to use the superlative degree as the rule says. The superlatives must not be used as if it were equal to very plus positive degree. The example is given over here. When we can write very plus positive, it is not necessary to use the superlative degree. Let's understand. He wrote a best book. Here, a best book is not necessary to write. It is a wrong statement. So how can we write? We can write very plus positive. So he wrote a very good book. He wrote a very good book. Instead of writing, he wrote a best book, we can write he wrote a very good book. This is the rule. You understand? Remember, don't forget. Because some rules are similar in nature, therefore it might be confusing students time to time. Therefore, don't be confused. Try to understand, clearly understand. When problems, you can communicate. Okay? So that you will have clear informations. Let's understand the next rule. You understood this rule? Okay. Here is the next rule for using adjectives correctly. What it says? Let's understand. So, double comparative or double superlatives double comparatives or superlatives should not be used in the sentence. If we want to use double comparative degrees and double superlative degrees to enhance the meaning of a noun, then it should be avoided. We should not use double comparative and double superlative. Let's understand from these examples. He is more clever than his brother. Here you see, more is a comparative degree, whereas clever is also a comparative degree. So we don't need to use double comparative degrees. Understand? What we should write? We should write, he is cleverer than his brother. Not more cleverer than his brother. He is only cleverer than his brother. Every sentence should have only one comparative or one superlative degrees. Understand? So similarly, see the next example. She is the most youngest in the family. She is the most youngest in the family. Here you see, most is a superlative degree, whereas the youngest is also a superlative degree, which should be avoided. So what we should do? We should only use, she is the youngest in the family. She is the youngest in the family, not the most youngest in the family. He is not more cleverer than his brother. And stick this rule. So we should, from this rule we understood that we should not use double comparatives and double superlative degrees in our sentences. If we have written, it is grammatically wrong. Let's understand the next rule. Here you see another rule for using adjectives correctly. What it says? Let's understand. If the first of two or more adjectives is a superlative, if in our sentence there are several adjectives are available and the first adjective is a superlative degree, the other should also be superlative degree. If the first adjective, if our sentence has more than two adjectives and if the first one is a superlative degree, the other adjectives in that sentence should also be superlative degrees. Okay? So the example is given over here. Try to understand. He is one of the best and hard working teachers of our school. So here is the best is one adjective and hard working is another adjective. Whereas according to this rule, if the first adjective of the sentence is a superlative, then the other adjectives available in our same sentence must also be superlative degree. This is the rule. So here from this sentence we understand the first among these two degrees, the first is the superlative degree and the second is not the superlative degree, it is the comparative degree. Hard working means you can say positive and sometimes can be used as comparative degree. So here to make it superlative degree, what we will do? He is one of the best and most hard working teachers of our school. So here, instead of writing only hard working, we have to write most hard working, because this sentence has more than one adjective and the first adjective is in superlative degree. So according to this rule, the other adjectives must also be in superlative degree. Okay? You understood this? Don't be in conflict. This is very important. So the first adjective, if it is superlative, the other subsequent adjectives available in the sentence must also be in superlative degrees. Clear? So let's understand the next rule.
The next rule for using adjectives correctly is that remember that if an adjective follows the phrase one of, if the adjective an adjective follows one of in our sentence, the phrase one of, then it should be in the superlative degree. If one of is used before an adjective in our sentence, then the degree of that adjective must be in superlative degree. Before the adjective, if one of, the phrase one of is used in our sentence, then the degree must be, the degree of that adjective must be in superlative degree. Okay, so let's see the example. He is one of the best boys in our school. This is the superlative degree, the best, because before them the phrase one of is used. Okay, so similarly, she is one of the most beautiful girls. She is one of the most beautiful girls of our school. Understand? So, when the phrase one of is used before the adjective, then the adjective's degree must be in superlative. This is the rule. You understood? So, this is the rule. Let's understand the next rule for using adjectives correctly. Okay? Don't be in confusion. Understood this? Clear. Here you see, we have given another instruction to use adjectives correctly. And what is this rule? Let's understand. A very common error is of the following type. Suppose some examples given. Here we have some common error. So what is that error? Let's understand from this example. The population of Bombay is greater than Delhi. The population of Bombay is greater than Delhi. It is wrong, because we are comparing between the population of Bombay and population of Delhi. So in that case, we cannot write simple Delhi. We should write that of Delhi. Understand? See, it should be the population of Bombay is greater than that of Delhi. Because here we are comparing between the population of Bombay and population of Delhi. We are not comparing two persons where we use simply them, or two things where we are using simply two things or two persons. But here we are comparing the population of Bombay and population of Delhi. Because the comparison is between the population of Bombay and the population of Delhi. So instead of writing the population of Bombay is greater than Delhi, we should write the population of Bombay is greater than that of Delhi. Understood? Clear? Okay. Let's understand the next such instructions. Let's understand the next rule for using adjectives correctly. What is this? You see, preferable, a word preferable has the force of a comparative degree. Preferable is itself a comparative degree, and it is often followed by the word to. Preferable to. Understand? So preferable is a comparative degree itself and is followed by to. And we must not say more preferable, because we cannot use double comparative degrees. We understood this earlier. Double comparatives, double superlative degrees should be avoided. So we can have only one comparative or one superlative degree conjugatively. So here more preferable is a wrong statement. Grammatically incorrect. So we cannot write, we must not write. We simply write preferable to. Let's understand from this example. You see, health is more preferable to wealth. You see, preferable to is there. Preferable itself is a comparative degree, and we cannot write more again before this preferable, because it will violate the rules. So, instead of writing this more, we can write only preferable to.
See, from this second example, health is preferable to wealth, not more preferable to wealth. Understand? So this is the rule. It is very easy to remember. Okay? And you can practice. Clear? Understood this rule? Okay. Let's understand the next rule. Here you see the next rule for using adjectives correctly. Let's understand what does it say. See, do not use less when fewer is required. You see, less is itself comparative. Fewer is comparative. From little is positive, little, less, least. Few, fewer. Understand? So here, when less is necessary, we should not use fewer. Less is used for quantity. Because for uncountable nouns, we use less. We can use. But for countable nouns, we use fewer because it is talking about the number. Let's understand from these examples here. See, less refers to the quantity or for uncountable nouns. Fewer refers to number or for countable nouns. Understand? So let's see the example. No fewer than 50 girls. Here 50 girls are countable and we are talking about their number. Okay? So no fewer than 50 girls took part in it. No fewer than 50 girls. Here 50 girls are talking about the number of girls. So well, it is countable now. Therefore we have used fewer. We cannot use no less than 50 girls. It will be incorrect because 50 girls, which is talking about the number, and we cannot use less over here. Similarly, no less than 10 pounds. 10 pounds means it is a quantity. It is a quantity, that like quintals, kilograms, understand? Liters. So here the pounds is a quantity, measurement of quantity of tea. Uncountable noun is needed. Understand? So, no less than 10 pounds of tea is needed. That means more than 10 pounds of tea is needed. So, here we have written less because here we are talking about the quantity of an uncountable noun. Therefore, we have used less. We cannot use no fewer than 10 pounds of tea. If we write it, then our sentence will be incorrect. You understood? From these examples, today also we have learned several instructions for using adjectives correctly for speaking, for writing and for our text. There are still more such instructions still there to discuss, and we will discuss the other such instructions for using adjectives correctly for speaking and writing in the next class. And for today, only this much. I advise all my dearest students, please go through all these rules carefully, try to understand. Whenever you have any kind of misunderstandings or problems to understand, you can directly contact me. I will surely clarify all your doubts by phone as well. Understand? So, I wish everybody must go through these rules because this is the second period of our topic, the correct use of adjectives. First period, we did understand several instructions for using adjectives correctly. Today also we understood several instructions to use adjectives correctly. And in next class also, we will discuss, we will try to understand some other instructions for using adjectives correctly. For today, only this much. Okay? Wish you all the best. Thank you.